Why did we wait so long for this one?
Because it took a long time to finish. We didn't wait. We had to make you wait. I apologize. But I finished touring on Sing the Sorrow and immediately started writing December Underground, which took about a year to write and a year to record. And so as soon as we felt that it was completed, we released it.
So, I mean, you did a lot of touring, is that right?
Yeah,
because I read somewhere that you've done a lot of touring.
Yeah, we toured for about 14 months on Sing the Sorrow.
Oh, that's 14 months?
Yeah,
a long time. Is that like around the world twice or?
Yeah, approximately.
Okay.
Yeah. Should I be addressing you or you?
Just you can chat to me. That's cool.
Okay,
tell us, what was it that you hoped to achieve from this album? Was there anything specific?
Nothing specific other than we wanted to make a record we were proud of. We wanted to advance artistically and move forward. We were really happy with Sing the Sorrow. We wanted to do something more grand.
Something more grand?
Yeah, we definitely wanted to do that.
Kind of to describe grand, is that musically grand or sort of thematically grand? Or?
There you go, you got it. Musically, thematically, aesthetically, we wanted it to have a big feel without losing moments of intimacy, which I think we've achieved.
Yeah, because I mean, we have a thing we offer about death by Pro Tools, yeah. Like you can lose a lot of the soul in the machine.
Yeah, definitely.
You've got organic richness.
I think we can achieve both. I mean, it certainly doesn't sound like a lo-fi record by any means. I mean, it sounds like a very big, rich, grind record. But I don't think it lost any of the intimacy, any of the true feel of the songs.
Cool. Okay. Also, you guys are known for making like big stylistic leaps. You know, maybe in part because of gaps between albums. What do you think is the stylistic, the sort of musical leap between Sing the Sorrow to this one?
I mean, it's hard to put into words. I mean, it's definitely a different record. If you listen to December Underground, you listen to Sing the Sorrow, they're markedly different, which, as you said, is the case for each release that we put out. It's a larger sounding record, as we were discussing earlier. I think it's more focused in the songwriting. I think there's intricacies in the songs. Vocally, I'm doing a lot different vocally as well as lyrically. And there you go. There's a lot of differences.
Okay. And were any of those sort of conscious? And how much was accidental? Like that's quite good.
I mean, it's mostly like that. It's mostly what you described. It's not quite accidental, but when we write and when we record, we gravitate towards works that are different for us and that are fresh and new, and those are inspiring to us. So that is what drives us to create records that sound different from one another, because when we write something or come up with something that seems too reminiscent of something we've done in the past, it's not exciting anymore. It's like, it's okay. It's kind of like, this seems like it could be on Art of Drowning more. Although the records changed drastically, for the most part, I think with the instance, for instance, December Underground, I think anyone that appreciates Sing the Sorrow appreciates December Underground. So if you stick with us step by step, I think that you're always, or likely to be okay with the changes. I mean, if you look at December Underground and you haven't listened to it since 1994, then no, you're not going to like it. Well, I mean, that's my first New York. If you've grown since 1994 as well, then maybe you will. But it's because the changes are gradual and appropriate, if you will. I mean, there's certainly bands that we get into and we change as people as time goes on. We listen to all sorts of different things, but nothing musically really directly influences what we write. I mean, we sort of write in a bubble attached, and I mean, really what influences most is us, our working with each other and working off each other. And, a lot of bands have that direct influence, where they say, we always listen to was Bowie, or all we listen to was Beatles' White Album before we wrote this. It's a direct inspiration, but it just doesn't work that way for us. I could see how it would for other people, but that's just not who we are.
Okay. So, does technology kind of influence a lot? Because, when you're in the studio, and if you've got the luxury of spending a lot of time in there, then you're like, oh, I like this sort of twiddly noise and this, and you can see that a lot in music stuff, stuff.
I mean, definitely, as music advances and technology advances, and instruments advance, and that will affect music in general. If you're willing to work with those new tools, Jade's an amazing programmer. He's been programming for at least 6 years now, and so that has an influence. sense in that respect that it, you know, it broadens our palate. At that time we're talking about the luxury of being in the studio, broadens our palate, simply, if only to allow us time to do what we want to do.
And after as many hours as you guys, it's 7 albums,
somewhere?
It's
6, 7, yeah.
How come you kind of haven't exhausted whatever it is that inspires you? You know, I mean, even Oasis, like 2 albums. Come on, we write about, we can't write songs anymore. You know what I mean? And they were gutted because they thought they'd always write those amazing songs. Oh, yeah. So how come?
Yeah. I think there's been a lot of things along the way that have attributed to that. I mean, we've had band member changes that you know, contribute to the sound hugely. I mean.
Okay.
I don't know why they're all looking at me. you know, with each new band member addition, the band became rejuvenated until we got to the lineup now, which is the most solid lineup we've ever had. You know, and artistically, we've really become comfortable with each other. And so there's that. We always are changing what we do to some extent, so that's always exciting to go into writing and say, okay, we're going to do something different, let's see what it's going to be. And it's always a surprise to us because, like I said before, we don't have a pointed style of writing, you know, we don't have a direct direction that we want to go in, so we just sit down and see what's cool. So all that, and just, you know, we love doing this, so.
That must be quite exciting, though, again, actually reading the air, isn't it? But like, we practiced the songs of the album, 9 tracks, practicing, going to the studio and recording. Is it less like that, but in the studio, the songs kind of get to take form a bit more? Or is it that you definitely have, you know, your songs down and you go to the studio and record them?
We do what Aerosmith does.
Oh, really?
Like, we're the same thing. Some of those will already be integrated in there, and we'll play them while we rehearse off the computer.
Of course, yeah. Okay, just quick, I think I've got the minute sign from Matt. Tell us why we should buy the new album.
Because I love it. Because I'm really proud of it, and I think a lot of people could enjoy it. I think if you're a music